You're watching Tag TV.
India is well known around the world owing to its historical background, diverse cultures and interesting traditions. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in the field of science and technology, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I'm your host Uzma Jafri, and today in our episode of My India, we will take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country, stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. Celebrated in the month of Chaitra, which typically falls in the Gregorian month of March and April, Chaitra Navratri is one of the most revered festivals in Hinduism. Dedicated to nine forms of goddess Shakti, the festival celebrates the victory of good over evil. This year, as Prime Minister has announced 3-week lockdown across the country to combat coronavirus, the temples are lying barren as people prefer to perform all the rituals at their residences itself.
Temples in India are lying barren during the 90-long Hindu fasting festival of Chaitra Navratri, which is dedicated to the Hindu goddess of power Durga, as the country began its 3-week lockdown to combat coronavirus. Temples across various cities, which are usually bustling and are packed with a sea of devotees every year, are looking abandoned as Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi has announced a complete lockdown of 21 days to curb the spread of the contagion. The 9-day fasting festival of Navratri is celebrated with much fervor across India. However, coronavirus fear has dampened the spirit of Hindu festival this time. In the capital New Delhi, only those people who live very close to the temples are visiting these holy sites to pay their obeisance, that too in very few numbers.
Chaitra Navratri aaj se prarambh ho chuke hain, ye jo bhakt khade hain sab aas paas se aaye hain, jaisa Modi ji ne elan kiya complete lockdown, bhakton ka koi yahan pe jamavada nahi. Jo 4-5 bhakt aap dekh rahe hain ye sab aas paas ke, yahi prarthna karne ki he mata rani, इस जो महामारी है इससे देश को मुक्ति मिले.
In Amritsar and Varanasi too, few devotees are seen thronging the temples to offer their prayers, rest of performing the rituals at their home itself. In Mumbai city's famous Mumba Devi temple, priests on the first day of Navratri performed rituals within closed doors to mark the beginning of the festival and prayed for the eradication of the coronavirus epidemic.
Maa Mumba Devi se naimittik roop se prarthna kar rahe hain, he Bhagwati, is jagat mein mahamari se bachav karna aur jo ye mahamari phaili hai uska jaldi se jaldi si navratri mein nivaran ho.
Navratri is celebrated in the honor of nine manifestations of Hindu warrior goddess Durga. Durga is depicted as riding a raging lion, holding weapons in her 10 hands. It is believed that during Navratri, goddess Durga descends on earth, ridding it of demons, and blesses the devotees with happiness and prosperity.
Having compassion and regards for others, this is what all Indians believe, no matter which religion they belong to. Be it happiness or sorrow, they have always stood by each other's side, and the same can be witnessed nowadays when the country is in the grip of deadly coronavirus. Recently, special prayers were performed in Jammu and Kashmir's Rajouri district to give the message of love and brotherhood and help country combat the contagion. Have a look.
Prayers for peace and prosperity in the nation resounded high in the Pir Panjal range of the Rajouri district few days ago as devotees gathered at the shrine of Saint Fateh Muhammad Sahib to pay their obeisance to the saint. Said to be the greatest saint of his time, he is known to have spread the message of love and brotherhood throughout his life. Today, as the country is suffering with deadly coronavirus, the devotees offered special prayers at the saint's tomb for the well-being of humanity.
इस वक्त पूरी दुनिया जो कोरोना वायरस की शिकार बनी हुई है उससे निजात के लिए कि अल्लाह ताला हमारे इस मुल्क को और हमारे जम्मू कश्मीर में और पूरी दुनिया के लोगों को इस मौजी बीमारी से महफूज रखे और इसके लिए खसूसी आज दुआ भी की गई है आजकल खानकाहों में मस्जिदों में मदारिस में और मुकद्दस मकामात पर दुआएं की जा रही हैं कि अल्लाह ताला इस मौजी बीमारी से लोगों को महफूज रखे
Sufi saints have always taught us the lesson of humanity, and today, when the whole world is battling against COVID-19, it is the need of our that everyone stand beside each other, irrespective of their caste and community.
Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
Security personnel in the Union Territory of Jammu Kashmir's Baramulla district recently carried out disinfection drive to stem the spread of deadly coronavirus as the cases of contagion climbed above 400 across the country. Jammu and Kashmir Police along with India's Central Reserve Police Force sprayed disinfectant on shops and public places including bus stands, taxi stands, hospitals, banks and post offices.
गलियों में जो पब्लिक प्लेसेस हैं बस स्टैंड टैक्सी स्टैंड हॉस्पिटल बैंक पोस्ट ऑफिस और बस के जो लोग स्टाफ होते हैं जहां लोग वेट कर रहे हैं हम सभी जगहों को डिसइंफेक्ट कर रहे हैं पब्लिक को जागरूक कर रहे हैं उनको मास्क और सैनिटाइजर दे रहे हैं
जम्मू एंड कश्मीर एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन आल्सो बैंड द एंट्री ऑफ फॉरेन टूरिस्ट्स इनटू द टेरिटरी एज अ प्रिकॉशनरी मेजर एज सून एज द फर्स्ट केस वाज रिपोर्टेड Following a call from Prime Minister Narendra Modi, thousands of people across the country cheered loud for those working on the front line during the coronavirus pandemic. Many stepped out on their balconies and courtyards with steel plates and spoons in hand. Some wore face masks as they cheered and beat their household utensils. Others played instruments and drums to show their gratitude for all efforts being made in the fight against coronavirus epidemic.
Today in our section of Asia Buzz, we will take you to explore some of the famous tourist spots in Japan. Hokkaido Antenna Shop, which provides its customers food and drinks from different local regions in Japan, is the new addition to the list. While the thrilling climbing attraction, Muscle Monster is also emerging as new adventure spot in the country. Take a look.
This delicious ice cream is made with Hokkaido's famous Yubari melon taste. It is the only shop in Tokyo where visitor can buy it. It is called Hokkaido Antenna Shop. These kinds of antenna shop provide customers with food and drinks from various local regions in Japan. Many of the customers are local who miss the taste of home and others are tourists who want to try the most famous foods of Japan without traveling to distant place.
全国の特産品を集めたお店ですので、はい、全国のいろんな特産品が、自分の手に入ることができます。街から村からですので、そこのところの街とか含めまして 1200 アイテムぐらいございます。
Antenna Shop first appeared in Tokyo in the early 1990s. It was established to help a regional government to promote local products to Tokyo's many residents and visitors. Much like an antenna that picks up radio waves from all around Japan, Antenna Shop 2 is a place that picks up goods from all over the Japan. Some places even offers an onsen, that is, hot spring experience. Antenna Shop also introduces different prefectures' experience by sharing their culture and sightseeing spots. This Antenna Shop is for Shizuoka Prefecture, which is famous for its green tea. Customers can learn here about the history and types of green tea while enjoying a cup by themselves. Antenna Shop is a great place to find all these unique goods without traveling. This thrilling climbing attraction is called Muscle Monster. It is built high on the mountain, overlooking Sagami Lake, to test visitors' physical and athletic skill as well as challenge their fear of heights. It is only 2 hours away from Tokyo and one of many attractions of Sagamigo Resort Pleasure Forest.
92 種類のアスレチックから構成されているアスレチックエリアと屋上の展望台、それから横にあるジャイアントスイングの3つから構成されているアトラクションになっています。
The obstacle course starts with 15 minutes training session with careful instructions on how to handle the equipment properly and safely. They also have English instructions to help foreign tourists. The course is very safe. Everyone wears a harness with 2 safety cords that have magnetic clamp attached to the belt. This clamp clip onto the wire. There are 2 clamps and you are able to be unattached only one at a time while walking on the rope to keep safety. The obstacle course has many unique challenges for people to try, ranging from bicycle, a bird swing and suspended table. These challenges will test people's mental and physical strength, but when challengers complete it, they ring the finishing bell.
Beautiful scene that we have never seen in Hong Kong because there are full of mountains and lakes, and which is a very natural scene, which is very no pollution. So I think this is good.
This obstacle course has a spectacular outlook during the whole challenge. However, if you wish to have a look at the view without doing the obstacle course, there is also an observation deck to enjoy the beautiful scene. There is also Tarzan Mania and Picasso Egg, which are smaller obstacle courses. It is enough for kids and adults to fear heights. Sagamigo Resort Pleasure Forest is a great place for everyone to enjoy the beautiful nature near Mount Fuji.
India is a kaleidoscopic society. It has embraced diversity at every step of its formative history, be it religions, customs, languages, food, art, or any other variability. The society has metamorphosed itself, maintaining a great deal of balance and harmony among its subjects. Establishing this fact, a Muslim man from Uttar Pradesh's Bareilly district is pulling out all stops to revive the age-old temple that has severely destroyed with time.
In 1857, a temple of Lord Krishna, Mohan Mandir, was built in the Patti village located in the Senthal Nagar Panchayat of Uttar Pradesh, Bareilly district. Its foundation was laid by Mir Muhammad Zafar, the younger son of then Nawab of Senthal, Ghalib Ali. Carrying a huge historical significance, today this temple has completely demolished with only small structure left on the place. So, in order to bring its previous glory back and get it reconstructed, a Muslim man, Urfi Raza Zaidi, who belongs to the same village, is making all his efforts for its revival, presenting a big example of communal harmony.
Mohan Mandir jo hai wo symbol hai 1857 ke swatantra sangram ka. Iski kahani ye hai ki jab 1857 ka ghadar hua aur usme Nawab Ghalib Ali sahab ko मैसेज मिला खान बहादुर खान का जो कि रोहिलखंड के पूरे के नवाब थे उन्होंने कहा कि हमारी सपोर्ट में अगेंस्ट द ब्रिटिश आप लोग आएँ तो उसमें नवाब ग़ालिब अली साहब ने 40 गांवों की एक फ़ौज जिसके सिपे सालार मोहन यादव खेमकरण यादव थे उनकी सदारत में भेजी और अंग्रेज़ों से लड़ाई हुई लड़ाई होने के बाद जब खात्मा हो गया इसका इसको कुचल दिया अंग्रेज़ों ने इस क्रांति को तो उसके बाद सेथल के सूली वाले बाग के अंदर खेमकरण यादव भोले बेलदार को फांसी दी गई और उसी के साथ साथ नवाब ग़ालिब अली साहब की प्रॉपर्टी जब्त की गई और नवाब ग़ालिब अली साहब को उनके घर में नज़रबंद कर दिया गया जो आखिर तक रहे और उन्होंने अपने बेटे के साथ जो कि जिनका नाम मोहम्मद जफर साहब था उनके साथ मिल के खेमकरण यादव और भोले बेलदार की याद में इस मंदिर का निर्माण कराया ये अपने टाइम गुजरने के साथ साथ ये मंदिर जो था वो गिर गया तो इसकी हमने और लोगों की सपोर्ट से मिलके इस मंदिर को बनाने की सोची क्योंकि आजकल की सोसाइटी में अगर इस तरीके के काम होते रहें तो हिंदू मुस्लिम इत्तेहाद के लिए एक बहुत अच्छा मैसेज जाएगा
Zaidi's effort have finally paid off and the government has assigned 10 lakh rupees for the reconstruction of the temple. It would now be developed both a religious site as well as a tourist place. Villagers believe that once this temple is constructed, it will be a symbol of Hindu-Muslim unity.
ये बहुत बढ़िया कार्य है और एक हिंदू मुस्लिम के लिए एक बहुत बड़ी मिसाल बनकर ये मंदिर उभरेगा ये बरेली जिला में ही नहीं पूरे भारत में और विश्व में ये जो है जाएगा कि एक मुसलमान व्यक्ति ने एक मंदिर के लिए इतना बड़ा सहयोग योगदान दिया और ये मिसाल बन जाएगी जैदी साहब की
It's people like Ufri Raza Zaidi and their initiatives that are playing a great role in strengthening the secular fabric of our country.
With change in lifestyle, pattern of human habitation and occupation, the quantum of waste produced is increasing every day and is naturally a matter of concern as it is not just increasing the landfill space but also deteriorating the environment. So giving this waste material a touch of creativity and incorporating it into something unique is the best way to deal with it. Many people across the country are implementing this and contributing towards Prime Minister's Clean India mission. So today in our lifestyle section, we bring you a few examples where people have turned trash into treasure. Have a look.
The site that was once a dump yard is today enfolding in it the beauty of world's seven wonders. Located in the country's capital, New Delhi, the 2-hectare landfill site was converted into a park by South Delhi Municipal Corporation as a part of Clean India project aimed at incorporating ways to recreate iconic structures. A group of seven artists were working with discarded material for the past 6 months to create these masterpieces that include replica of Taj Mahal, the Eiffel Tower, the Statue of Liberty, the Leaning Tower of Pisa, Christ the Redeemer statue in Brazil, the Great Pyramid of Giza, and Rome's famous Colosseum. Through the installations, the city has remodeled hundreds of tons of waste into art pieces, which are now expected to be a world-class attraction. Moreover, the park is planned to run through natural energy such as solar panels and windmills, and spreads a strong message on recycling waste, besides giving access to people who don't have a chance to see the original monuments.
दिल्ली में अभी आप देख रहे होंगे तो स्क्रैप्स बहुत ज़्यादा हैं और गाड़ियाँ कितनी सारी है, डे बाई डे कितनी निकलती है. तो उनका कुछ ऐसा प्लान था कि SDMC का कुछ ऐसा स्क्रैप जो बुरी जगह पड़ा हुआ है वो एक अच्छी जगह प्लेस हो जाए और लोगों को अवेयरनेस मिले कि हाँ यार, ये कुछ अच्छी चीज़ हमने देखने के लिए एक पार्क वगैरह जो भी बना वो सारा स्क्रैप से यूज़ हुआ है. क्योंकि बहुत लोग ऐसी ऐसी अच्छी चीज़ें बहुत एक्सपेंसिव पैसा लगा के बना देते हैं, बट उसका है ना एक मायने नहीं होता. मीनिंग होता है कि एक बुरी चीज़ जो वेस्ट जो मतलब एटमॉस्फेयर को भी गंदा कर रही है, और वो हमने एक अच्छी जगह प्लेस कर दी जो बच्चों का एक एटमॉस्फेयर बन जाए.
Another such example where an artist creates wonders from waste material is witnessed in the city of beautiful Chandigarh. Named as Chandragupta Dhawan, this retired officer not just makes the best out of waste, but his creations also carry a unique message along with them. Based on several themes like love, friendship, safe environment, gender equality, women empowerment and humanity, Dhawan has been able to create more than 30 miniature models till date, and the number is surely going to increase with time. All his items are beautifully displayed in a park adjoining his residence, which due to his creative artworks is now known as Small Rock Garden of the city. Dhawan will soon be displaying his creations in the upcoming Rose Festival, an annual floral carnival of Chandigarh.
अखबार में मेरा दैनिक भास्कर में दो तीन दफा मतलब नाम आ चुका है. भी इन्होंने भी बड़ा अच्छा इन्होंने शिक्षा मतलब दे दी, मतलब उन्होंने कला के थ्रू शिक्षा देने की कोशिश की. इन्होंने रोज गार्डन में इस फरवरी में जब लगता है उसमें, तो उसमें इन्होंने मैंने परमिशन दे दिया है, तो वहाँ पर वो मेरा कहते आप डिस्प्ले कर सकते हैं, भी लोग आपको कला को देख सकें वहाँ.
By adopting such creative attitude towards waste materials and using them in a best possible way will not just create a clean India, but also a better and beautiful country to live in.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@anin.com. I'm your host, Uzma Jafri, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.